Now we will learn how to give the early pay discount to customers who pay quickly for an invoice that has discount terms. Let's imagine on March 4th, Holden did 5 video hours and 5 editing hours for customer Betty. We did this job on account, which means we'll make an invoice, and we will use Betty's default terms. After you open the invoice window, set the date to March 4th. Notice as soon as you choose customer Betty, Betty's default terms comes here on the invoice, 210 net 30, just like we set up in the previous video. We know that it's going to be 5 video, and we know it's going to be 5 editing, and we already learned several times how to create an invoice. Creating the invoice is easy, especially considering the terms for that customer come up by default. We click Save and Close, and when we take a look at the open invoice report for Betty, we notice something interesting. This most recent invoice that we made has a different due date than the date that it was actually made. If you look more closely at the other open invoices, you will notice that all the other invoices have the same service date as the due date. That's because if you do not put terms on an invoice, QuickBooks automatically makes the due date of the invoice the same as the date that you made the invoice. However, on this very last invoice for Betty, you can look a little bit closer on the open invoice report and see a little more clearly that even though all the other invoices have the same due date as the date of the invoice, this is the only invoice we made that we put terms on, and that's why the due date is different. Remember, it was 210 net 30. 30 days after March 4th is actually April 3rd, because March has 31 days. Now let's see what happens when Betty pays the invoice early enough to take the discount. Let's imagine on March 5th, Betty paid in full the March 4th invoice with check number 8472. We open the payments window, and we temporarily collapse the ribbon so that we can see all the invoices. We put the date that we got paid, March 5th. We put the payment method check number 8472. Now notice what happens at the moment we choose Betty. All of her open invoices show up in this window. Now notice for the very first time in the customer payment window, we now have this column called discount date. That's because we have just recently given customers terms on an invoice. Before we gave customers terms, we did not have this column. To select the invoice that we're paying, do not click the check mark in the margin. Just click anywhere in the row, but do not click the check mark. First, click the row, but make sure that this stays unchecked. Now we need to open the ribbon. Of course, in order to see the invoice when the ribbon is open, we will have to scroll down from the right scroll bar. At the moment the correct invoice is selected, we come to the ribbon, we make sure we choose the main tab, and we click discount and credit. Notice QuickBooks knows the money amount of this discount is going to be $44. Notice QuickBooks also knows the balance due will be $2,156. We will have to assume that Betty wrote us a check for $2,156 because she is paying and taking the discount. Now, QuickBooks is asking us for which account in the chart of accounts will record the discount. We only have to set this up once, and QuickBooks will remember for future customer payments. We click the down arrow, and we find the account that we set up in the previous video. Here we are, early pay discount. We click that, And from now on, QuickBooks will remember that that's the account that holds all the discounts. When we click Done, we notice that the discount of $44 is applied. That means that the money amount should be the amount of Betty's check, $2,156. When we push the Tab key, QuickBooks automatically selects and places the check mark in the margin of the invoice that we applied the discount to. So again, you, the bookkeeper, have to double check that the payment amount matches the original amount due minus the discount. If everything checks out, we click Save and Close, and when we open the trial balance, we notice that we have early paid discount showing up for the first time in the trial balance as $44. What about making an invoice that does not have the default terms on the invoice? For example, imagine on March 6, we did 6 video and 6 editing hours for Betty on account, which means we make an invoice, but we will not put the default terms. Instead, we will put the special terms that we made, good customer terms. This is a term on the terms list that we made in the previous video. Again, we will open the invoice window and we will let the ribbon show. Of course, we will put the date as March 6. And of course, at the moment we choose Betty, Betty's default terms immediately appear in the terms field. We will now change them to the terms that we want for this specific invoice. This does not mean we're changing Betty's terms permanently. It means only for this invoice, we are giving her different terms. We will put 6 for the quantity and choose video. And on the next row, we will put 6 for the quantity and choose editing. Now we have an invoice for $2,640 where the terms are good customer terms. After we click Save and Close, we will get a warning message that we have changed Betty's terms. Do we want to change Betty's terms permanently? In our example, we will click No because we want good customer terms for only this invoice. Now we again open the Open Invoice Report. We look at this most recent invoice here at the bottom of the Betty section, and we notice because the invoice date is March 6th, the due date is April 15th. If you remember the terms from the previous video, the good customer terms had a due date 40 days after the date of the invoice. April 15th is 40 days after March 6th. And that's why the due date that shows on open invoice is April 15th. Now let's imagine on March 7th, Betty paid in full the March 6th invoice with cash going into undeposited funds. We open the payments window and we put the date March 7th. Choose cash for the payment method. Make sure that it's deposited to undeposited funds. And then as soon as we choose Betty, we see her open invoices. And again, we would have to scroll down to see the one that we're paying, or we could temporarily collapse the ribbon. Once again, do not put the money in the money field until you confirm that you're getting the discount. Click anywhere in the row of the invoice that Betty is paying. Do not click the check mark. Instead, reopen the ribbon after the invoice is selected. Probably it's a good idea to stay at the bottom by scrolling down. And then we click discount, or make sure the main tab is chosen, and click discounts and credits. Notice QuickBooks knows that the discount is $79.20. Notice QuickBooks remembers that we need this account to record all of the early pay discounts. You don't have to put that in anymore. You put it in on the first one and QuickBooks remembers. double check that the cash that you got from Betty is $2,560.80. When you click OK, the discount is applied here, and once again, the difference is $2,560.80. So if Betty gave you $2,560.80, when you push the tab key, QuickBooks knows that's the amount due for this invoice because she's paying within the discount date. When we click Save and Close, we can reopen the trial balance and see that early pay discount has now increased to $123.20. When we open it up, we can see it's because of these two payments from Betty for the two different discounts for the two invoices where we gave her terms.